meeting to order. Just stand with me, we'll have Pastor Greg Young, who is chairman of Baptist Church, lead us in prayer and remain standing for the pledge.
Let's pray. Father, what an opportunity it is to bring this meeting and this group of leaders before you tonight. We pray that you would give them wisdom as they seek to follow you and do what's best for this community, for these neighborhoods. We pray that everything that's said and done tonight would bring honor to the name of Jesus, for it's in his name we pray. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mayor Bibb.
Here.
Alderman Decker.
Here.
Alderman Hudson.
Here.
Alderman Corbett.
Here.
We'll entertain a motion to discuss or approve the agenda.
Motion to approve the agenda. Second.
Okay. Any opposed? All in favor?
Aye.
Approval of minute of the February 17th board meeting and Alderman meeting. Entertain a motion to discuss or approve this.
Motion.
Second.
I move that we approve the minutes.
Didn't you do that?
Yep.
He did that. You need a second.
Second.
Okay. Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Want to welcome our visitors. Everyone that's here, appreciate your interest in what's going on. Thank you for coming. We have one public hearing, ordinance 2201, an ordinance to amend the municipal code, title 12, building utilities, etc. codes, chapters 1, 4, 1, 2, 4, 7, and 9. I will open this meeting, and I don't think there's anyone here to speak for, so we will close this meeting. Communications, Alderman, John Corbett.
Nothing for me.
John Decker.
I'm good, thank you.
Cliff.
I'm good, thank you.
Okay. Louder. Okay. I want to thank, before you do.
Yeah, sure.
We had a wonderful budget retreat this week, going over where the city is and how it stands, and the requests from the department heads, and I mean, it was a very, very good meeting. And there's only a very good meeting because we've got some hardworking people in the city that put all the information together for us so that we could keep up to date on what's going on, and I really appreciate that. So with you and the rest of the city, thank you. Okay, Jerry.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor. The town center water line construction is still progressing, and phase 1 and 2 will be complete. They're about ready to connect it to the community center here, and then they're going to have to test it for water purification. And once that's done, phase 3 will begin, where they'll start going north underneath College Street, and we're going to cross 31W a little bit further down. The design plans for the tennis courts are in final review by CSR staff. I talked to Jason this afternoon, and he's down to like 99.5%, so it's just, I should be getting it early next week. We'll still plan to bid that project out by the end of this month. R.G. Anderson has requested an extension to the end of April to get substantial completion for our community center. I know it keeps changing some of our plans that we've been trying to do, but we're getting there. Most of the internal work now is finished. We're waiting for like 3 hard copper AT&T lines to be installed because they have to connect to the fire alarm, the elevator, and the wheelchair lift in the board conference room. As it stands today, we're projecting to have furniture installed during the month of May. We hope we can have staff move into the building sometime in early June or mid-June. We would like the first official meeting in the building to be the BMA meeting, June 16th. That's what I'm hoping to do. I don't have any other meetings there by any of the boards until this board has an opportunity to be the first. As soon as sit in those chairs and make those decisions. We will plan on having a ribbon cutting and the time capsule, what they term that, and Don Eden Community Room dedication. We'll have an open house. There are regular BMA meeting at 7 o'clock, which we normally do June 16th, but right now we're considering a starting program around 5 o'clock, 5:30 at the latest. But we'll post more details as we get closer to that. Mandy will be working with me on that, trying to get that set up. Staff will be. Work continues on the sewer plant expansion each work day. Reeves Young gives us a daily report. You've been given yesterday's data log so you can see some of the projects being made on Friday. You know, it's kind of outside of my mind, way out there at the industrial park, but it's a big project. You know, we're talking $21 million. The amount of concrete that they're pouring out there is unbelievable. High, tall, it's an interesting plant. It's basically we're building a whole new plant that replaces the other one. Work continues on the sewer. Yesterday at our GNRC meeting, we had a briefing from Nashville Area Chamber of Commerce on their vital sign study. This is an annual publication. I've given it to you in the past. Each of you have been given a copy so you can kind of look at it. There was much discussion concerning the fact that they are projecting that, this number, 200,000 more people will locate to Middle Tennessee within the next 5 years. Yeah. 200,000 people. The high demand for housing and the shortage of supply is causing our housing costs to go up. Here's another key point that really was kind of like, wow. It's at the point that 41.9% of the respondents to the survey spend more than 30% of their household income on paying their mortgage or their rent. Or if you're over 30%, it's considered housing cost burden, but they're way over that. So over, you got over 30% is considered house cost burden. The conclusion was that more housing supply is needed. So an additional 200,000 people, I figured, would require somewhere in the area of 70 to 80,000 new units. This information prompted much discussion, I can assure you, amongst city leaders who, like we, are under much stress from voters from not wanting more growth. We're hearing it, all the cities are hearing the same thing, but there was no clear solution was given. So these 200,000 people, they just want to come to Nashville. It's amazing, but something that all the cities are just struggling with right now, trying to figure out how to house all these people. So anyway, that's all I have.
Jerry, I understand that the growth is more prevalent and more vigorous in South Williamson County in Columbia and that area. They're talking about Spring Hill was a little city when GM bought the factory there. And for a long time, Rockville had 10, 12,000, 11,000 people. And they're now
amazing. It's just amazing what all the cities are dealing with and growth. And so the arguments you're hearing in our planning commission are the same concerns you're hearing in planning commissions all across Gallatin. Gallatin, the mayor was concerned, saying that they want more affordable housing, but what the problem is that there's no supply. You ask realtors, they can't find houses to put up for sale because of the supply is so low. And so how do you do that?
If you don't do that, the next step is government housing is coming.
Yeah.
And we don't want.
Yeah. But in the meantime, the prices are going to continue to skyrocket. So if you own a home, you're in good shape. It's going to continue to keep going up the values. More people come here because your housing value is up as the demand goes high for the housing. So
good report.
Yeah, thank you. That's all I have, sir.
Do they acknowledge your reports?
I move we acknowledge the reports.
Second. Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Consideration of the following resolutions. Resolution 2203, a resolution to support restoring the historic revenue sharing relationship between the state of Tennessee and its local governments, and to return local share of single article cap to local government. Entertain a motion.
I make a motion we approve.
Second.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion?
this is something the Tennessee Municipal League has launched as their number one priority for legislation this year with the legislators. They're pushing, and they give you the history in the proclamation, in the resolution when you review it. You know, I think our we could have brought in next year almost $200,000 in last year revenue if they were giving us that extra tax that they took, that they stopped. It's not that they took it away from cities, they just didn't give it to cities when they expanded their sales tax increase back years ago. Will this make it through the legislation? Will the state do it? I don't have high hopes for it, but I've asked all the cities to do resolutions, and I've kind of trailed behind some of the other cities on this one because I just didn't think it was going to be, it would get much ground running at, you know, state, at the Capitol building, but it seems like there's a number of senators and House members that are supporting it, but like I said, we'll see how it goes. What I'm hearing right now is that they're thinking about doing the recommendation coming back to the legislators that maybe that this may only be temporary, so don't make it a permanent thing that you're going to give the cities, so maybe give them a little temporary, you know, few crumbs maybe for this year. But we'll see if that even happens. But legislators still meeting, they'll probably meet for another month or so, and then we'll hear more as it goes on. But they would like this resolution sent to them, and that's what our angle is on this.
Any other discussion?
Question. It's interesting that the city receives 92% of all the state's total sales tax. Mm-hmm. We're working for nothing, aren't we?
Right. Yeah. They collect it all, and then they give us mandates, unfunded mandates to follow.
I'm sorry, sir. That's okay.
Any other? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Yes, so moved. Consideration of the following ordinances, ordinance 2201, an ordinance to amend the municipal code, chapter 12, building utilities, codes, chapters 1, 2, 4, and 7, and 9. This is the second reading. Ask for a motion to either discuss or approve.
Motion to approve.
Okay, and second.
I'll second.
Okay.
Hey, this is the bringing the building code to 2018 from 2012 since the state adopted it. State gone to 2018, so we're just following suit, doing what we're required to do.
Mm-hmm. Any questions? All in favor?
Aye.
That's a roll call vote.
Oh, okay.
Second read.
Yeah, roll call vote.
Alderman Corbett. Alderman Decker.
Aye.
Alderman Hudson.
Aye.
Mayor Bibb.
Aye.
The next one is ordinance 2202, an ordinance to amend the municipal code, title 12, chapter 5, housing codes, sections 12-501 and 12-502. This is a first reading.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Second. Yeah. Okay. Questions? Comments?
This was a piece of 2201. We left it out just to double check to make sure nothing changed in the ICC code book. They have some wording, and we looked at it and suggested we just go back and double check that nothing changed, nothing was added. So it's all the same that was under 2012. It's just, you know, we're going to 2018 now. Just double checking. That's why it's separate.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, so moved. Ordinance 2203 is an ordinance amending the municipal code, title 7, chapter 2, fire codes, section 7 of 201 and 7-205. I need a motion. Motion we approve.
Second.
Okay, questions for Jimmy?
It's basically the same thing as the building code. It was a meeting behind. We wanted to double check some wording on some things, so we went over that, and we were just following suit to bring the fire code up to match the building code.
They're always behind, ain't they?
Yeah.
Any questions or discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Get moved. And we have no purchasing, no other business, no discussion items, and other information is none, so we will be adjourned.
I'm sorry?